me just end right there. They're the ones who gave you Satan to worship on Christ's birthday. Oh, hell. Oh, we got to tell him Christ born one day. We got to tell him he rose another day. Because that's when people generally are born by a woman. We have a birthday. And when we die, we have a day of death. But he has a day of resurrection. And we don't know none of it. Mm-hmm. If it's true, what the Bible said, I can understand why they don't know his real birthday and they don't know the day he resurrected. If there's some truth to it, he came from the messenger Gabriel, that Mary's gonna have a baby named Jesus. I still can understand why they don't have his birthday or his resurrection day. But he's the greatest thing that ever touched this earth. He has so much honor in him that people just don't want to honor him. He has so much grace, peace, love, King of Righteousness, King of Shalom. They was envying that. So they would disguise everything about him to make us forget. Because the more people could remember the true Yeshua, the way was, what he said to draw all these people into him, we've been drawing them people in too, right? How about the book? I love Paul for some reason. Because Paul said right after Jesus left, y'all went teaching another doctrine. Is this the doctrine we reading today? Where's the real doctrine at? What's the real doctrine? He said you're so far from the gospel of Christ. And I believe it's that way today. I believe it's that way today. I do. Yes, I believe it's that way today. We're so far from the truth. Preach the gospel of Christ, preach the gospel of grace, preach the gospel of prosperity, gospel of peace, gospel of hope. And Christ came preaching the kingdom of heaven. So which one is it? Christ didn't even say. let me just make sure he didn't say that. I'm just going to go to the book of Mark for you real quick. I'm just going to make sure what he said in the book of Mark. Y'all know Mark, right? Okay. He did say gospel, but what gospel of what? Now, I got you. I got you, preachers. I got you, pastors. I got you. Right here in the book of Mark. And this is how they add to the Bible and take away from the Bible. It says here, Mark 16:15. Go ye into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. Stop the gospel of what? Because this is Christ speaking, you automatically say the gospel of Christ. Christ came preaching a different gospel. I'm sorry, people. He came preaching the kingdom of heaven. I'm going to shut it down right here. There's two different gospels going around. I would suggest that you figure out, even Christ says, seek ye the kingdom of heaven. Not the gospel of Christ. Christ knew it wasn't about him. But the Romans will make you think it's about Christ, so you forget the one who created Christ. That's why they say in the book of Romans, you worship the creation more than the creator. I get it now. Christ was created by Yahweh. We worship Christ more than we do the creator. You get that? Christ is not to be worshipped. He's to be worshipped. Yeah, because he's the way of Yahweh. He's the truth of Yahweh. He's the life of Yahweh. And except a man come to him, we have to go to him and say, Christ, look, I'm sorry. I repent. I've fallen short from God. I'm a sinner. I need to get back to Yahweh. Once I accept you in my heart, I have, because even again, Yahweh dwells in temples, okay? We've been told a lot. Remember, you got to remember, Greeks and Romans are very mythological. Mythological. Very mythological. Mythology. And when you read some of this Bible, it's magic and mythology and mythical. And God say that black magic, that voodoo, that witchcraft, the hoodoo, that mythology, the sorcerers, and oh my goodness, it says it all in the Bible, yeah. But we do it anyway, because the people who gave us this religion gave it to us. But when you read the Bible, it's a little mythological. Listen, I told you, my tongue is Hebrew, African, it's not Greek. But you give me some letters, give me some Hebrew and some African words, off the tip of my tongue. These Greek words, I'm not feeling nothing. Only thing Greek I really ever liked was back home in Hudson was the Olympic Diner. Yes! They made some good food up in there on Warren Street. Hello! But other than that, I'm not Greek. Anyway, it say, preach the gospel to every creature. So what the first person do? I'm going to go out here and say, preach the gospel of Christ. We're going to preach the gospel of Christ. But does it say, preach the gospel? Maybe I got to look my other ones to double check. I know he ain't say it in the book of John. He ain't say it. Whoop. Nah, he telling Peter what's going to happen to him. When you was a child, you went where you had to go, did what you had to do. But now, Peter, when you get old, somebody going to lead you somewhere you wish you had no business going. And I said they led him to the Roman, the Vatican, and crucify his ass upside down. Yes, I do say that. I do believe that's what happened. When Christ said, verily, verily, I say unto thee, talking to Peter, when thou wast young, thou girdest thyself and walkest whither thou wast go. But when thou should be old, thou shalt stretch forth thy hands, and another shall gird thee and carry thee whither thou wouldst not go. And Peter wouldst not have gone probably over to that Roman Catholic Vatican Church, be crucified upside down, if he was not led there as Christ prophesied to him. And I think Christ did this to let him know, you denied me, maybe, Peter. You a little off course here, but Christ was prophesying to Peter. Because when you get to the book of Acts, you read what happened to Peter. Okay? So in the book of John, it doesn't say, go ye into all the land. Let's just go to the book of Luke and see what Luke said. But I won't make this point. Because y'all gonna stop messing with my Jesus, my Christ. No, I really love him, probably more than I love anything in this world. And to sit here and see the one thing that I'm trying to use to get my life to the next level sometimes tear me down, because I sit in here every day like, God, what is true, what's not true. Thank God for discernment, for the Holy Spirit, and for the anointing, because it lets you, it leads you. You follow them. You're led by the Holy Spirit, the Bible says. When you worship in spirit and truth, the Holy Spirit take you to the truth. So, let's see here. Verse 46 in Luke, and that will be Luke 24. Thus it be written, and this behooves Christ to suffer and arise from the dead the third day.